Now, all composers, when you think of people even like Cole Porter, Let's Do It and other things, everyone loves to write about these lusty months of May, June, or July when the bees are buzzing and everything is happening. And this is just a great one because it's June, and June is busting out all. Song that ewes and rams mate in August. I said, no one else is going to know that but me. I'm leaving it in because he's the purist. But he had it, so that's a stump the stars thing you should know about. And poetic license. The next song, a beautiful song that really expresses the predicament that Julie Jordan has. She knows she's being led in the wrong direction, and it's the wrong guy, and it's the wrong love affair. But she thinks to herself, what's the use of wondering? I can say all of this, but it's just talk. So here's what's the use of wondering.
Thank you. It was going to be abbreviated, but go on, finish. But I just wanted to mention that no less a critic than Irving Berlin considered this song the equivalent of the 23rd Psalm. Pretty high praise for the Dean of American, for the Dean of the Great American Songbook. So here's Aver to sing, "You'll Know a Walk Alone." Oh,
gorgeous, right? Beautiful harmony. And now we move from Carousel to the Flower Drum Song. We're gonna switch time periods. We're actually moving to 1958. And 1958 is 7 years after they did The King and I. So there's been a real hiatus between hits for Rodgers and Hammerstein, and sort of a personal story for them is that they're not in terribly good shape at that point, physically. Oscar Hammerstein has just come out of the hospital for an operation on a stomach ulcer, which will turn into stomach cancer, and he'll be gone in 2 years, just as he finishes off The Sound of Music. And Richard Rodgers, who's got lots of compartmentalized aspects to his life, needs to work to almost maintain his sanity, and he hasn't worked or succeeded for 7 years, and he's has an alcohol problem and a mental health problem. He's in pain with me for 6 months. So just to let you know that successful people still have problems. but someone in the industry, I think it's one of the Fields brothers, and that's Dorothy Fields had two brothers, both were very much in the theater business. Brings them a book written by C.Y. Lee. It's a book called The Flower Drum Song, and it's about, they're always attracted to clash of cultures. That's just what The King and I was about, and that's what you'll see South Pacific is about. And this book is sort of an internal clash of cultures because it's about the Chinese community in San Francisco, in Chinatown, and the younger people who are much more Americanized than the older generation that are still holding on to their traditions. And the whole plot is kind of galvanized by the arrival here on a boat of Mei Li, a young Chinese girl who's here only with her flower drum and the venerable wisdom that her father has taught her, and a letter of introduction to her father's oldest friend, who happens to run a dilapidated theater in Chinatown that still puts on the old Chinese operas. And he has a son who even helps him to do this reluctantly, because his son would like, whose name is Guan Ta, would very much like to change that place into a nightclub for the younger generation. So you see the sort of differences. But Mei Li walks into the theater and watches the old man and his son acting out the parts. As a matter of fact, the young boy at that point is dressed in the woman's garb, because many times they switched roles, male, female, in Chinese opera. And he takes off his makeup, and she takes one look at him, and he takes one look at her, and they fall in love. So what else? And in any case, the next two songs we're going to do from Flower Drum Song illustrate the incredible knack that Richard Rodgers has of giving an Eastern sound to music that still works for a Western ear. Not an easy task to do. And so we're gonna do two songs here. One, all together, that sort of introduces the venerable wisdom that she's carrying from her father. And the second song is a love song that he sings to Mei Li.
Says that children keep growing, rivers keep flowing too. My father says they doesn't know why, but somehow or other they do.
Dark blue curtain is pinned by the stars, pinned so much is going on along the Yangtze River or the Tiber or the Don. 100 million girls. A swallow in Tasmania is sitting on her eggs, and suddenly those eggs have wings and eyes and face and legs. 100 million girls.
Gently your eyes look back on mine. Clearly you are.